Welcome back guys to my YouTube channel. So a few days ago I had made an introductory video about the digital clock that you can see right behind me, and it was received quite well by the community. So as I had promised, I am going to start with a tutorial series. This, as you may imagine, is the first part of the tutorial series. Since I haven't built it completely yet, I still don't know how many parts it's going to take, but of course it has to take about 4 to 5 parts at least. So let's crack on with the tutorial. So once you have a large enough area, large enough to create a clock as big as this, of course you're going to be doing this on creative, so might as well do it in a super flat world. Once you have the area ready, just come down, place one block like that. Now this is going to be the starting block. Now build up 13 blocks to the top, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13, and then count across 9. So already we have 1, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and just bring it down like that and just connect the ends up. So that's the frame of the whole thing done. Now take out your redstone lamps and just place them all in this area like that. So you should be having a 7 by 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Perfect. So once you've done that, you should be having something that looks like this, and this is the face. So once you've got that ready, swing to the back. Now this is going to be the front side and this is going to be the back. So come to the back and make a 8 design. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like this and that. So you should be having something that looks like an 8. And this is what I was trying to explain as the 7 segment display. As you can see, there are 7 lines. So now we'll be wiring up the thing. So each of these blocks, when powered, will be powering the redstone lamp in front of it. So individually we'll have to power each and every one of them. So now follow along. Place a block there, a block here, break this block and place 3 like that. So they should be like a step like that. Do the same at the top, like this, and at the bottom, like that. Now from each of them, bring out 1 more, and 2 in the middle. 1 more, 2 in the middle, 1 more, 2 in the middle. So you should be having something that looks like this. So now to power them up, place a redstone torch on the last block of each, with 3 repeaters like that on each, all on one tick, and redstone dust connecting the whole thing up like that. And now you should see the 3 bars at the middle are on. So 3 of the 7 segments have been lit up individually. So let's see how to do the second one, that is this side. So follow along again. 1 block here, 2 blocks like this, 3 blocks like that, and again 2 blocks like this. So you should be having something that looks like this. So now let's connect this side up. Place a repeater here with redstone dust on all the blocks except this. That's where your redstone torch is going. Now put a block here to stop them from connecting. Break this redstone and put it back again. Now come down to the bottom where this block is, break that block, put 2 blocks up like that, and a redstone repeater like that on one tick. So you should see this side as well lighting up. There we go. Now just repeat the same thing on the bottom half. Break this block and I'll just speed through the whole thing. Should be it. There we go. Now it's showing a 3. So now we'll move on to the next part, that is the right part of this face. This is going to be different from this side only because the circuit should not connect with the next face's circuit. That's why it's going to be a little bit different, but essentially it does the same thing. So follow along again. Make an L-shaped thing, an inverted L like that. Now bring it down one, across one, bring it down one again, two like that, and across like this. Place your torch on top of that, a block like this, a block like that, with a repeater, a repeater, and redstone dust like this, with this slot being another repeater. Now just go down over here, break this block, put a block like that here, another block, and another block like that, a repeater here, and redstone dust like that. So you should be having the 3 on like that. See, it's showing a 9. Now all you have to do is just repeat the circuit we did right up there over here. I'll just speed build the whole thing. Like that. So it should be complete, showing an 8. So now that's the whole clock face built. So one more thing we have to do is color coding the different terminals, which is actually an advancement for the next part, so that when we're doing that and coding the wool for changing the face of the clock as per our wishes, we'll need to color code them to know which terminal goes where. So just color code them like this. You'll need black, green, pink, orange, blue, yellow, and red wool if you want to do it exactly as I'm doing it. So the top left should be black, the bottom left should be green, the bottom one should be pink, the middle one should be orange, the top one should be blue, this one should be red, and the bottom right one should be yellow. So these are the points at which we are going to be connecting the plug thing, so that we can change the face as per we want. So that's pretty much the whole clock face built. So that brings us to the end of this first part of the tutorial series on the digital clock. If you are liking this series, please do leave it a like, and of course share, comment, and subscribe for more videos, and of course the next tutorial. Bye guys.